Sometimes I wake up with the urge and shakes. Freestyle before, during, and after the wake and bake. I'm here, but I'm so outside space. I am a human doing knuckle, fuck the race. Who wanna taste the ghetto gourmets on deck? Words sharper than a blaze and I get you shut, knuckle. I do it to ease the voices in the dome. You might see me talking to myself when I'm out on the road. Sometimes it's freestyle, most times I really am. Welcome to the life and times of a motherfucking madman. Lashing out eases up the noise a little, and banging on my chest might even hurt a little. But with this pain there is pleasure, with this pleasure there's a smile, with this fire there's a garden. I'm about to burn it down. I show and I prove and I lead by example. I am live and direct and y'all niggas just sample.
Yeah, the way we do it can't nobody else emulate. Doing 90 as I'm flying up the interstate. Get out the way, homie, keep my lane clear. I've been here for a minute, I ain't going nowhere. I'ma do it till the wheels fall off. Keep drinking till I see it's all gone. Word is gone, that's how we get it on. I do it like I do it because this is my song. Gallo on the roll again, coming through. And I don't say excuse me, man. Sober, I don't know what's his case, cause he said he don't drink, but took a bottle to the face. You damn right, champagne is always in season. That's all I'm gonna say, homie, I got my reasons. Don't care if you agree, it don't make difference to me, cause you don't pay my bills and you ain't paying me. So go and tweet about it, come see me in the streets about it. 140 characters can't describe this, how I feel about it. Is he really bad? You wanna find out? Just cause I'm smiling, you don't think that I would wild out. See, that's what I like, you think I'm soft, I'm like, I. My baseball bat solve all of my problems. I don't have to worry about a fist fight. Plus my squad is a wild, but trying to get riled up, it's like we got Spartan power. Normally I don't fall back, but tonight it's like the world is ours. Yes. The way we do it, can't nobody else emulate. Doing 90 as I'm flying up the interstate. Get out the way, homie, keep my lane clear. I've been here for a minute, I ain't going nowhere. I'ma do it till the wheels fall off. Keep drinking till I see it's all gone. Word is gone, that's how we get it on. I do it like I do it.
Yo, why they do this? Tell me why they do this. Man, you put me on this beat, I treat this whole like prostitution. Trick it out, 16 bars, call it deuces. If you don't like winning, we all the solution. The squad with a mutant, regarding the music. We're waiting to align with the stars that are shooting, a shooting. The crew and I've been chosen for the Truman. It's written in the cards, we gon' do this. I don't believe in tarot, no, I believe in tariff. Half Captain Jack Sparrow and half Captain Planet. I do this for the booty, Lucci and cuties with smiles.
Oh, you bringing back Lucci?
Excuse me, sir, Lucci's never out of style. Cause a rose by another name still will smell the same. And the king of any land's the man who understands. But instead of slinging crack, I sling this thing that says abusive on the streets. They call it rap music, that's why I do it. So
the way we do it, can't nobody else emulate. Doing 90 as I'm flying up the interstate. Get out the way, homie, keep my lane clear. I've been here for a minute, I ain't going nowhere.
See, I started in lounges and now they book them for Coliseum. It's so amazing, they buying tickets to come and see them. Go check my clothes, they asking me if they European. I laugh at them and tell them, no, it's Europe I be in. See, I travel the world, hope they follow my girl. And I came out of Harlem, never begging a pardon. It's true, I was out looking for stardom. But see, that's a dream that never came overnight. Neither did rocket science, and now that we mid-flight, I laugh with the story, this is about how we spent last night. Niggas throwing the him up, I was waving the six. It's only a few eyes that I could throw in the mix. Only a few guys who ever did it like this. So shout to the first lady who riding with my clique, and I know, she know. We pop a bottle of Mo. New state, new day, I'm still rocking the show. Been on the block till the D's come. Sipping that red rum, shorty wanna head sprung. I let her eat the gun, she wanna go dumb. I'm feeling all in the buns, I'm ready to hit and run. But man, am I having fun. Fuck it, what's a mop without a bucket? Met a slim goody, you can call him is lucky. Hanging at the bus stop, bowling on the budget. Other niggas laughing, but baby, I does it. Fuck it, baby, I love it. See me, I whip the dreams with the cream like custard. Get it? Cream like custard. Bitch, never understood.
Sunday, check us out on DTFradio.com, the grown man show, hosted by Sir Bottles, a.k.a. C Black the Business, a.k.a. Knuckles.
DJ Uncle Tone and myself, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. You know what I mean?
Heard that, but I ain't know that. I ain't never heard that drop before. Yeah.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome. This is the Grown Man Show. DJ Uncle Tone, D Burgess, and C Black. No, hold on. Let me rephrase that. Johnson Mathematics, once again, and S Street Media.
S Street Media.
C Black, DJ Uncle Tone, and D Burgess. We in the game. Like NBA action. How was your week, C Black?
How was my week? Talking about my week. I had a bad week, man. I lost my phone.
That sucks, man.
That's the connection and everything. You know, you feel lost to the world when you don't have no phone, no connection to nothing. So for the last about a week, yeah. I've been
What about your computer? Can you still connect with people through your computer?
But I work, so I'm outside. I can't work with a laptop.
Gotcha. So
that ain't cool.
Did you back it up?
That's dangerous. Most of my stuff backs up to my. It backs up to something.
So. You got the clouds.
Not the cloud. I don't have a cloud, but I got it. Backs up to the Google
Drive.
Yeah, I got the Google Drive. So.
Oh, okay.
So everything's gonna be in. I just gotta get it first.
Just gotta get it.
I gotta get it. So the phone is actually delivered. It's just business is closed at the moment, so I can't.
Hold on. How can you be C Black the business and business is closed?
Well, I'm 24/7, so that's a different. The business, the establishment where it is.
It's closed. Okay.
Yes.
I thought you was on your Jay-Z. I'm a businessman, not a businessman.
I can't make people open. After hours.
Okay.
You gotta wait till the next business day.
I get it.
The next business day.
Seemed like the business said it.
Wow.
Next business day. I like that. I'm going to use that in the tagline. The next business day. Mm-hmm. I really like that.
That's hard, son.
I want to, you know what? Mathematics act like I didn't notice his sneakers. Right, the NBs that match the shirt.
Yeah.
And I would say I'd get a pair, right? But I,
74s, man.
I, you know, I got to get a different color.
Of course.
It has to be red, though.
All red?
Yes, all red. All right,
let's move.
If possible.
I never seen an all red pair of NBs, though.
I used to have a pair, and when I pledged my fraternity in college, I had a red pair and a purple pair.
What did you pledge?
Huh?
What did you pledge?
The Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
You? You're a Q, dog.
You're a Q? Been a Q.
Wow.
I'm not shocked,
but I am shocked, kinda. You know what I'm saying? I shouldn't.
Yeah, you know, I'm what they call.
I didn't know this. I knew this guy for many years, and I never knew he was a cute.
You never knew that?
I don't think I knew you.
Hold on, let me.
I never seen your brand. Your brand where?
Let me ask you. Every cute don't get branded.
All right.
Right.
I didn't know that either.
But let me ask you a question. You've been to my house,
correct?
As you walk in, if you look by my staircase, there's my paddles from Omega Psi Phi. And my crest.
I'm going to say I noticed the paddles, but not that it was Q-Dog related.
Oh.
How about that?
Okay.
Can that be possible?
That's possible. Yeah.
That's what happened.
Yeah.
But now
it's there, and my Masonic stuff is on the other side of the house.
That's what I thought it was related to. Now, so what was your line name? What was your line name?
Psycho Dog 2.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, so can I ask? I don't even know how it works. So we seen all school, we seen school days, you know. But
how I did, pledged that fraternity too. D5D, I pledged that too. But that was that was in the movie. It was Gamma Phi Gamma.
Gamma Phi Gamma.
On in reality, it was Groove Phi Groove.
All right, so my question has nothing to do with none of that. I want to know how names are brought up or came about. Like, how do or who does decide who gets what name? Or, you know what I'm saying? And I know most of the time it goes off of like things like personality or something they did or something they do or you know what I'm saying?
How yeah, often? You asked, you answered your own question.
So that's it. So who? But who,
yeah, it's
but,
it's based on your personality. Let's say C Black is the only person online. Mm. You will automatically get Lone Dog.
Just that's. Has that ever happened? Like, it's only yes, been one person what, online before? That's crazy.
Yes, that has happened because, you know, pledging is based on, one, your grades. You got to carry a 2.5 GPA average at all times. Two is based on your personality. Three, it's a little bit of popularity, too. So
that wouldn't have been, none of those things would have been a problem for me.
You was a ball player.
Yeah, yeah. So yo,
you would have been automatic.
Let me tell you something crazy though. In high school, like watching these movies and things like that or whatever. Funny thing is, and my favorite color is red. So this is really the only reason why I actually
thank you
wanted
for
to
saying
be a Kappa.
That.
I actually wanted K-A-Z? To be a Kappa. I wanted to be a Kappa, right? So when I got to my school, shouts to Albany State University, HBCU.
Yes,
you
already. I know my niece went there.
I seen the Kappa flow, and I was like, that's not me. I couldn't rock. But you know who I did rock? Like, I could see myself being, like, down with them was the Alphas. They was more of the C Black smooth vibe.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I didn't rock with the people that were Alphas. Even though that doesn't matter, and it shouldn't matter. But it did matter, because I didn't end up crossing or getting online or nothing. I just stayed on the basketball team. But all of those, I check all the boxes, though.
Shouts to 1908. That's Alphas.
That's that.
Yeah, that's the year they was founded. Mm. 1908. Omega's 1911. The Delta's 1912.
Those were good times, man.
We did that, the Divine Nine. Shouts to the Divine Nine. Shouts to the Divine Nine. And it was brutal back in the days. And I'm going to leave that there. But we had fun. We had fun. We had to do our thing. Off the air, I'm going to tell you some stories, but not live. You know what I'm saying?
Understood.
Shouts to my brothers. All right? My bros.
Them days was wild, I'm sure.
It was good. It was good. And then I took it up a notch and became a Freemason. I could say that live on the air. I became a Freemason, a 32nd degree Freemason at that.
Now, you know I know what none of that means.
That means I'm kind of top of the food chain as a Freemason. Yeah. Top of the food chain is 33rd degree. I'm right there. I just, financially is different.
So how do you gain steps or whatever?
It's a whole lot of initiations. Yeah, a lot of initiations. Shoot, and then after the 30 years of being a Freemason, it's been a lot of initiations. Shouts to Mariner's Lodge number 67, First Manhattan District. Yeah, that's me. We did that. You know what? Now that I think about it, now that I'm talking to you, it's a lot I haven't done.
As far as what?
Masonically, Greek fraternities, two of them, you know, street. Like, that I won't mentioned because that's different, right? But I make music, and I DJ.
That you do.
And guess what? You bless me with the opportunity to be your co-host, and I'm happy for that. So salute to you. Yes, you messed around and woke up the savage beast. Yep. And then everybody all week, I'm going to ask you what you think about this. Everybody called me all week to talk about Diddy. What do you feel about that situation?
Damn. I don't really want to talk about that. What do I feel about Diddy's situation? Tragic. It was bound to happen. The truth was going to come out eventually. Some people are making statements by forcing, you know what I'm saying, showing that he doesn't have as much power as he think he does. Giving him more than a slap on the wrist, you know what I'm saying, showing him, like,
right,
sit yourself down, you know what I'm saying, you're not bigger than what you know what I'm saying, it's not about you. But yeah, it's tragic, man, like, can't stop, won't stop, but it's about to stop. It's about to be over.
I wish my comrade the best. And I have to leave that there. But I wish him the best. We've known each other for a long time. And I wish him the best. You know, a lot of things is going to come through fruition with a lot of artists in the music industry. My thing is, and I want to ask you another question. Uh-huh. You know, as my partner in crime, right? Why a lot of this don't happen with rock music? Why a lot of this don't happen with country western music? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I don't have an answer for that, but I'm going to give you my answer. So I want to start with our people a little bit more flashy and a little bit more arrogant with their activities and actions. So that brings a little bit more attention to what they're doing.
Right.
So that's probably why, that's where I think it comes from, that you know, enforcement want to slow you down from, you know what I'm saying, being braggadocious or, you know what I mean, whatever.
Right.
So that's what I think that's one of the main reasons, because I don't think them rock dudes is like, they might buy a jet, but we don't know about it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And they... space.
Yeah, that's what they do.
But they ain't bragging about it. There's no pictures. There's no, you know, we did this. We flew here to Dubai and, you know, all that stuff. They're not making it hot or bringing attention to themselves, pretty much.
Right, but isn't the whole thing about being an entertainer is about you bringing attention to yourself?
Yeah, of course, but some of the braggadocious parts aren't, you know what I'm saying, appreciated as much. I'm not saying anything wrong, but what do you see wrong in what I'm saying? Is what I want to ask.
No, I don't see any wrong in what you're saying, because, you know, I mean, we could go back to classic artists that's gotten in trouble for what they've done, you know. Like, James Brown.
Facts.
Yeah. Michael Jackson. So, hold on.
All right, so why you think he's being attacked then? Why, or not attacked, I shouldn't say attacked, but why you think the rundown is coming on?
What I know and what I think is two different things.
All right, what you know and what you think, both.
I can't say what I know. What I think is, you know, he had such a big run with a lot of his artists that the artists themselves started coming at him and started to, if you read the headlines or you read the internet, you'll see his artists he's worked with that's attacking right now. And they got proof. And he got cameras in every room of his house, in both houses. Right, I won't state the states, but it's online. It's public record.
I've been following. I've seen all that.
You know, then there's a security guard, allegedly, speaking out about it and stuff like that. So, like I said, I wish him the best, and I hope he sees this through, you know. And fortunately for him, he has a lot of money to fight.
That helps, right?
That helps.
Always helps.
That always helps. When you're a broke N-word, you stuck. You're done.
It's a wrap.
It's but a when wrap. You're a super rich N-word, and that's the money publicly that we know about, uh-huh. The side hustle is not even counted in that. So, you know, shouts to him. Shouts to Howard University, where he went to college at. Yep. What's that? HSBCU?
HBCU.
Yep.
Another HBCU.
Yeah. You know why I'm mad, though, C Black?
What you mad about?
The college I went to wasn't, what did you say?
It wasn't an HBCU.
It wasn't an HBCU. When I went there.
And then they turned into an HBCU.
And then it turned into an HBCU.
That kind of sucks. But you can still say you were there before they turned into one. So
yes.
That's cool too. I'll take that. Because it naturally off it was a black environment, so you was at the school, it just wasn't considered. It wasn't considered HBCU. Right. So you still went to it.
Yeah. You know? I went there.
It was so cool that they had to turn it into one. This is what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying?
No. Yeah, it was cool.
You made it so cool. And the time you was there, they was like, hold up. We need to make this an HBCU. Because you here. And that's how it happened. That's how it started. I'm going with that.
All right. And you know, I want to shout out this thinking about that. Shouts to Killer Ben. You know, rest in peace. He used to come to the college and visit us.
Who's that?
Killer Ben is my man from Fort Greene. He got murdered a long time.
Rest in peace.
I'm not telling my age. Well, everybody knows I'm old. But anyway, he used to come visit the college. Shout out to Botch. Oh, man. Botch is the homie. The first candy red Benz with the airplane kit that I've ever been in. Yes.
What year was this?
Oh, shoot. This was the 80s. This was the 80s.
Good call.
The second one I was in was in Oakland, California. So I've been in two. And I was like, with the airplane kit? Are y'all serious? With the... Do you remember the big cell phones in the car?
That had this.
With the big box and. Yeah, boop.
Like,
what?
I think of Die Hard when you talk about that. Die Hard and the limousine.
Both of them had that.
Damn.
Yeah. Yep, I want to shout out to Jerry and Dean Hodges out of Oakland, California. Those are my guys. They gave me my third record deal. Yep. But anyway, I was telling somebody earlier today, and I want to see how you feel about this, that Lord Tariq and Peter Guns got in trouble for the record Uptown Baby. Uptown Baby. We wear the crown, baby. If it wasn't for the Bronze, this rap stuff.
Damn.
And I personally feel that that killed their career.
Absolutely. It did.
Yeah.
I believe that too.
You know, they
didn't see no money from that song.
No, what happened was,
that's terrible though.
The song was a big hit.
Yeah.
Right? One friend from the group Steely Dan. Steely Dan made the original song, right? Long, long ago. And one of their friends heard the record, called them directly. Now, you know, Steely Dan is a band. It's not one person.
Right.
And called them and said, did you give these guys permission to use your record? Nope, they didn't clear the sample or nothing and got sued bad.
Forever.
Yeah. And this is God rest his soul, but this was after James Brown sued everybody.
He was doing the same. They was doing the same to him.
Well, yeah. Listen to Harry B and Rakim.
Sample everything. Yeah,
everybody sampled James Brown.
Ain't he like the
James
most
Brown.
Sampled artist or something like that?
James Brown is the most sampled artist. That's cool. Yeah, one of them. But yeah. And I'm just like, oh, shoot. You can't do nothing. You got a minuscule of seconds to sample a record before you can get sued. Uh-huh. Their whole song was Steely Dan. They right. just rapped over it.
Yeah.
And this ain't the, you know, it wasn't a mixtape record. It was a big radio record.
They ain't know the business, clearly, right? That's what.
Clearly, whoever's was managing them. Yeah, didn't advise them properly to pay to clear the sample.
Right.
And it wouldn't have been much.
To clear it?
To clear the sample. No, it wouldn't have cost much.
How much does sample, clearing samples, like.
Depending like that. On the size of the record, right?
Depending on how much you're taking of it too as well? Like.
No. See, the goal is, let's say I clear a sample with $1,500, right? Mm-hmm. But I include the artist. So that means the original artist would get residuals off of what I'm doing, depending on how big it is. You understand? So the original artist, let's say, in this situation, Steely Dan, right? If they had cleared it and paid that certain amount of money to clear it to the publishing company, Steely Dan would have got residuals and it would have been nothing.
It would have been all right.
It would have been nothing, but you get sued for over $100,000 and you just got on a label that gave you money to be an artist. You know, people don't realize, like, if I give C Black $2.5 million, I need my money back. So now you're signed to a label that didn't clear the sample. That money got to come back. So when you get sued, we're stuck. You're stuck, not us.
Not you yet. And that's what killed their career, because they couldn't make that money back.
No.
They ain't never have no other hit like that. The album was cool. It wasn't.
That album was cool.
It was all right.
You know?
It wasn't enough. They ain't going to platinum enough, I don't believe.
No, they didn't.
Probably still didn't go platinum.
No, they didn't. But
the album was all right, though. I will say that.
And you listen to, don't be mad at me when I say this, you listen to the greatest rapper alive when he said to Nas, I know who I paid, dog, Searchlight Publishing. That's extremely real in the music business. Uh-huh. So you pay in the publishing company before you pay in the artist.
Right.
But you know.
That was a calm flex by him. That was like the next ball.
Yeah. Well, Jay-Z's the greatest rapper alive. But and when I say Jay-Z's the greatest rapper alive, it's all around. Uh-huh. You know, business-wise, lyrics.
The total package.
He's a good dude, too. He's not easily trusting, though. But, you know, if you add the music business and the street, who's going to be easily trusting? Yep. How was your day today? I missed you. I haven't seen you in a week. But
right. My day was... I don't want to talk about my day, but it was smooth. Very active. Long walk.
Yeah. That reminds me of a Jill Scott song called Long Walk.
Yeah.
Good to go.
Yeah, but I'm getting old, man. That Today made me realize. Damn, yeah. Well, one of the days.
He said he can't know.
Yeah, because.
And we older than him.
Fact.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
You just starting.
You asked me about my dick.
Well, he did say his back was hurting.
And my back is in extreme pain, so I never used to be in this much pain, so that's why I know I'm getting old. Y'all are elder statesmen, but I'm getting up there too in age, you know what I'm saying?
Well, as the athlete that you were younger, pain is going to come with that. Nobody tells these kids that no matter what sport you play, when you get older, it's going to hurt.
Yeah, I'm finding out the hard way. Was never told that, never thought that. I thought you would just be in good physical shape for a long time, whatever. But I just stopped being as athletic. I stopped playing, whatever. It's all about work now. So, I mean, I play with the youth, the kids and all that. But
right.
I ain't going as hard as going and picking up no, let's go play a game or go up 7-on-7 football or anything. Now, I go to the batting cage, though. I get busy at the batting cage.
Word?
Yeah, yeah.
Yo, you gotta let us know when you go.
Nah, man, my shit be random. To be honest, my shit be random. But my goal, I'm about to go to the 60 mile per hour cage. And my goal is to hit a base hit. I hit a base hit in the 50 miles per hour. I'm going up to 60, you know what I'm saying? On it, though, son. I'm on it.
I would like to be there with you, man, on a random day.
That'd be dope. That'd be dope.
Yeah.
That'd be dope.
Why not?
That'd be dope, man.
You know I'm nice with that, right? Nice with that.
I don't doubt it.
You know I played baseball in high school.
And you know I didn't. I didn't play baseball. I'm just naturally gifted. Just naturally talented at, when I first got to the my employment, I was playing with the team job, right?
Right.
The jobs team. Is that right? Which one is it?
The jobs team.
Bang. And the referee won one of the games. I'm at the bat, whatever. And nice shot, whatever. He was like, yo, you ain't never played baseball before. I was like, how you know? He was like, because you just got a natural swing. And it made me think. When you just naturally athletic, I feel like Ocho Cinco out here. Like, you know how he be talking and you get crazy about how athletic he is? I'm just like, what if I would have and got, you know what I'm saying, on a team, on a baseball team, I could have learned like the tricks and the trades of being an actual baseball player. I'm just working off instinct, pretty much.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I got good hand eye coordination. So when
you're from where my favorite team is from. So that's natural for you.
Well, I guess growing up in the hood too as well. So, you know, you just play all sports just to keep busy.
Right.
Whenever everybody else is playing it, you're going to play it just to be included, right? And that was me. And I just got better at stuff than others.
And they got
a basketball scholarship.
Have you ever played stickball?
Come on, son, stop cursing at me.
A lot of people don't know what stickball is. That's why I asked the question.
We used to play stickball with a tennis ball. We used to play stickball with a handball.
Yes.
That's how you showed your how nice you was.
Right, with a stickball.
With the stickball. What?
What about the wiffle ball bat?
Stop cursing at me, man. Wiffle ball, we throw wiffle ball tournaments in my hood every summer. It's about to come up, too, actually.
Shouts to the X.
Wiffle ball, man? You know what wiffle ball is, Damon?
Yep. Whew. I'm a good wiffle ball pitcher.
And I wasn't. I used to want to be, but it used to hurt my arm because I used to try to get too crazy about trying to put too much spin on.
Nah, it used to hurt.
But, man, I'm on it. I wear contacts, man. I pay for them. They work.
Enjoy it.
Yes, enjoy it.
Enjoy it while you have it.
Right.
No, I'll be feeling funny when I can't see something. I got to put my readers on.
I'm getting there too, though.
I got to put the readers on just to look at letter from the doctor.
Like, levels of it. Like, I got to do the level thing.
Welcome. We've been waiting for you.
Yeah. I'm here. I'm on the bus.
Well, welcome.
I'm on the bus.
I sit in the front seat. So.
Didn't they make a movie like that? Get on the Bus or something like that?
Yeah.
Spike Lee did that. Yeah, Spike Lee. That was a dope movie.
It's a cool movie.
I think it was. Was it about the 40 Million Man March or something like that? Get on the Bus?
Nah.
Yeah, I think that was about everybody going to the Million Man March. Spike Lee did that. Get on the Bus.
What am I thinking about? I'm thinking about with a whole bunch of artists was on the bus. And they was going on a trip somewhere. I can't remember the name of that. But
that was to DC in the Million Man March.
Who was on it? Who was in the movie? I think we're talking about two different guys.
Giancarlo Esposito was in it. Of course Spike Lee was in it. God rest his soul. The guy that did the hold on.
We're talking about two different movies.
We're talking about two different movies.
Fredro, Sticky Fingers was in it?
No.
So yeah, we're talking about two
different. And it was a Spike Lee joint?
I don't know. It was somebody, of our genre and our culture that did it though. Mm. I don't know who was behind it, but it was called something like that. Get on the Bus or something like that. That's the one he's talking about?
Is that the one?
Yep. Get on the Bus.
Yeah, that you're definitely talking about two different ones.
Hill Harper was in it. I forgot that. Yep. Thank you, Super D. Yeah, check it out whenever you can get a chance and see what happens. In more news, right? What do you think about the brand new Taylor Swift mania?
I don't know what you're talking about, so I'm lost. I can't give an opinion on it, and nothing I don't know about.
Oh, no. Taylor Swift is bigger than ever right now.
Yeah, I know that. I just don't follow her, so I don't know how to respond to that. What you want me to say? No.
I mean, if you don't know about it, you don't know about it.
She's great. She's big.
And once Jay-Z took that last shot at the award show, was that the Grammys? Mm. It made her bigger. Mm. And I'm like, that has to be a plan.
Meaning what?
When Kanye took the first shot, right, on stage,
right,
she got bigger. She sold more records, right?
So you think they doing it on purpose?
I think the industry is designing it to do stuff like that on purpose to make her bigger. Now, mind you, if you saw it, Jay was like, Beyonce sold more Grammys than her.
Sold more records.
She received more Grammys than her.
Yeah.
Right, and she's the number one female artist.
Yeah,
which makes sense for him to say, but at the end of the day, it's just kind of like, you have a certain selection of human beings on the planet that listen to or are part of the Beehive, right, and then. The rest of the world listens to Taylor Swift. Because when you get nominated for Grammys and you win Grammys, that's based on people's perception of who you are.
So Taylor, they think Taylor's bigger than Beaton, basically.
Yeah.
Is what you're saying.
Yeah. That's why.
She'll never be bigger than her, then.
No,
Ain't nobody going to be bigger than Taylor Swift until she retires, right?
No, not currently. No.
If she's going,
and then you see what she did to this last Super Bowl. It was a Taylor Swift Super Bowl.
Yeah, all the camera on her.
Yeah, so everybody's worried about her.
Just to be cheering for her guy, right? That's it.
That's it. Ain't that a B? Now, I'ma ask Super D, aka D Burgess, to play some music for us. And the Grown Man Show will be right back. Once again, shouts to S Street Media and Mathematics. M is in the building. Tom is in the building. C Black is in the building. Z Fly probably went to the bathroom or something like that.
Tom. Ain't nobody fucking with the six. Ain't nobody fresher than the motherfucking six. As I look around, they don't do it like the six. And all these bad bitches, they want the.
It's not, cause everywhere we show up, we shutting down the spot. Who asked your opinion? Don't care about what you thought. Tone phone is a gun, cause he be calling the shots. I be balling a lot, don't like bragging about what I got. But what I pay in taxes, you couldn't make off the block. It'll probably get you locked though, because my flow behind bars like I'm a criminal. Sentence for my sentences, been menacing since I was a kid. And my clique ain't nothing out there like it. It's full of scholars and dropouts, businessmen and ignorance. We all about some dividends, mad energy, no riddle. A damn life, that hashtag. Now watch ain't nobody shipping with
six. Ain't nobody fresher than the motherfucking six. As I look around, man, I'm doing like the six. And all these bad bitches, they want the. Oh yeah. Yeah, I'm talking nice. Yeah, I'm talking cheap. Yeah, I'm talking mad. Nigga, I'm talking me. Yeah, I'm talking soon. Bottles yellow and tone. You ain't talking about money. Get the fuck off my phone. Yeah, I'm talking now. That's my first bone. Nigga, I got a nut now. I got an acorn. Talking that Google gaga like I'm acorn. And I'm fresh up out that soup like I'm A-son. You can't help it. Watching them perform, acting like you never felt it. Nigga, you a lie, so your eyes when you melt it. Keep it inside, you so motherfucking
ain't nobody fucking with the
six. Ain't nobody fresher than the motherfucking six. As I look around, they don't do it like the six. And all these bad bitches, they want the. They want them.
It goes uno, dos, tres, six. Motherfuckers, you don't wanna mess with. Blogs bugging out over the press kit. Get your pose ready for the press click. If you're asking me for my perspective, to put it simple, I am unimpressed with your bars and the part intervention. Sanchez niggas interception. You must be looking for a death wish. No protection, niggas moving reckless. In the game of chess, playing with checkers. In the gunfight with the knife inside of my necklace. Wu-Tang protection, next shit. You set trip, any VIP section you step in, rejected. Every bad bitch that you had is on my guest list. They won't even dance for them bands of imperfections. Respect my pimping, respect it. 12 vibe vixens for the click selection. While y'all niggas at home sexting, I'm busy re-ing up on contraception. They ain't fucking with the six.
Ain't nobody fresher than the motherfucking six. As I look around, man, I'm doing like the six. And all these bad bitches, they want the.
Bosses and the power moving, don't need it either way you need it, cause you independent, taking charge like a dominatrix, but you coming in our room, looking like a sexy waitress. Be the bosses that you are, they complete what you start, low key, hood stars, majors in water bars, internet, feeling large, cause I manage anything, include different genders, straight living sister, sender, born to lead, even though I took 16 years, but I'm here for a reason. Boys staying in the building cause I make you wanna dance. East Coast, more ride a bang. Showing love to NY, the lady bosses. And much love to the one for the lost man. Like they lost their losses. But you know what, the game ain't over. Now the game ain't over until I hit nationwide. New foul order. Get the world bubbling just like a soda.
I got
killing the boss, taking charge, bitch shit. Okay. My professions get me everywhere like transportation. One monkey can't stop the show. Not by myself, and you know the boss, lady hip hop, go knock. Gotta get it where I said it like tag side. These barcodes bad. Friends can't trust yourself. Just work has the fat star that you bought. Hey. Yeah, bust with the air guitar. Got the mic in my hand in the grill. Till your birds never play your part, just listen. Sound like little girl trying to play hardcore. With your broken words, no business mind. Get your A game up, cause the schools never miss you. Don't wanna be not taken seriously. In this industry, what the GP, triple threat, boss, say, see, yo, see, man. I do hit the bench, pinning 10. At the pattern, we hustle, my brother, you the boss. Taking his sauce, cause I'm blowing out the ass. Taking his sauce, cause I'm blowing out the ass. In the business, like Wall Street, ice, straight hood, baby, I'm the boss. Taking his sauce, cause I'm blowing out the ass. Walk up East Coast, introduce, baby, boss. Inside your head, baby, boss, work.
Every time I walk the streets, they got me watching my back. I ain't talking stick up kids. It's quite opposite that. They be dressed in all black, but they call the boys in blue. Am I judging my colors wrong? Ain't that funny? So are you.
True.
What I gotta do to make you not notice me?
You judge me by my clothes.
Stop and pose.
And always yelling freeze.
Is you cold? Well, button up your coat.
Cause all I know is racial profiling.
Is that how it's supposed
they
to be?
They say the street's safe for the suits and the briefcase. But who's protecting the working class for Pete's sake? Cause we slang and we bang where we stay. Even when it's cold, it's a heat wave. The block is a restraint. We can't even see straight. How we gon' be great when we live in a can't be state? We need faith, cause we ain't. Get a head start in the relay. And we ain't in charge, so we can't even relate.
You
fit the description.
Am I supposed to look when everywhere I go I get looked at like a crook? As a young god I was raised not to judge a book, but sometimes to cover off I have the world a little shook. Ha! And I'm splashing on them daily. No three ring circus, no Barnum, no Bailey, just the 3LB blowing out rings of smoke. And you better watch your rivers cause we flooding up the
they
coast.
They looking for
coast.
Dark skin, light skin, black, Latino, Arabic, jeans on, hoodie too. You look like the right dude. Someone they can stop and frisk, treat him like a pile of shit. Tell him he'll get over it. I hope the nigga try and flip, cause that's when they gon' dump a clip. Leave another body on the strip. Officer the Vic, send him back up quick. 1,000 witnesses, it doesn't count for shit. When the blind eyes adjust to see a soul is 3/5. Damn, in the times we speak about us, the modern age. When they try and throw us in cages, make us a modern slave. Working 7 days to be broke, thinking you got away.
What seems to be the problem?
You.
I
fit the description. You fit the description.
What you mean by
you. Fit the description.
I'm not being
description.
You got a whole dream fighting in reality. No justice allowed.
Coming from the judge seat.
You fit the description.
So
pay attention. Hoodie black with my New York Philly cap.
New York.
Colorblind, big sweet. You and I got great you. Super
fast. Yes, he made disguises.
You try to put your innocence. You see any book, just the base on your cuffs.
My motto's dare to be different. It better serves your interest to make some better friends if yours don't better your position. Listen, the way it's getting, they'll knock you for just talking black. That's fitting for the kids lost who don't want to rap. Whose coldest nap was by the bars, then the home and back. For holding packs to get their moms out the cul-de-sac. Like they call a sack when you charge on a quarterback. But where's the call when you charge for a quarter sack? Dare to be different, I tell them pick up a pen. Be wise and nurture a skill, I mean, spare the expenses. Cause law enforcement wants a young brother down. And if you're walking in your brown, well then you fit the description.
Co-pilot status, plus a nigga eyes 80. Quiet over the limit, but I swear we moving 80. So I ain't gotta talk, you can see it all up in my face. Shine like the sun, plus I'm higher than the wedding cake. And marriage is for suckers, but until I met old Mary Jane. Now I'm one of the biggest suckers this side of the Pecos, man. This fun is magical, that's word to the 3OB. And I don't need whales, cause a nigga quit the circle group. Gotta keep it gnarly, that's word to Bob Marley. If you like the collide, make my jump in the car seat. Cause I need the brushing up and you need some therapy. Aromatic commission partner, start with the G.O.D. Size 14, so I got it through it, bitch. Cause my lungs are like bags on the back of clinic, kid, huh? You have your opinion, well this is how a nigga lives. Stop getting mad and get like mad, nigga, roll a split.
I'm a star. They wasn't lying. Got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car.
Car.
Yeah. Roll up the font to break up the weed in this bitch. Pick out the stems, pick out the seeds from this bitch. Roll up the blunt, light up the green in this bitch. We gon' get high until we can't see shit.
Listen. Smoke something with your highness, the music innovators, MI6. Fuck a puff puff pass, take 5 hits. Exhale, did you notice you were flying? All I know is pilots, trying to see who's highest. Coke and Captain Morgan with a blunt to win the Heisman. Ladies get excited when they get invited to that first pull. Hit them in the chest like a trident. Now she's in the corner by herself, perspiring. Calling to her maker, God help. Church choir. Looking at my flood, thinking, surely know what time it is. Hey, get the fuck out, B. The homily. Wink, I'm a star. They wasn't lying, got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car.
Yeah. Roll up the font to break up the weed in this bitch. Pick out the stems, pick out the seeds from this bitch. Roll up the blunt, light up the green in this bitch. We gon' get high until we can't see shit.
I tell me, roll it up. Spark a set of blaze. I got a duffel of the green. I'm smoking purple sour haze. Homie, crime pays. So nigga, what your hustle like? These little niggas here still copping moisture lights. Chain shining in the dark like a nightlight. And you can spot me from afar like a light bright. Okay, turn them bottles rosé. Plus I keep a bad bitch and her name Mary Jane. I'm a star. They wasn't lying. Got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car. Come on, let's get high. I got some reefer in the car.
My music hot. Share my music. Turn my music.
will not lose.
Fucker, ever. Ever.
And we are back with C Black, Mathematics, and Thomas, and Super D. We're in the game. We're in the game, you know. So we're about to close out. Because, oh, shoot. You know, I don't do that kind of stuff. Yeah, we're about to close out. And I want to thank you, C Black, for another amazing episode of The Grown Man Show. And we have a party coming up. I'm just not going to say where online. We got a couple parties coming up. Yeah, Mathematics. We got a couple. So, and we're going to all be in form. And some of the events, we're going to be in rare form. Like, no. Like, it's going to be different. It's going to be the same, but different.
I feel like I know where you're leading with this.
You know, like, you know, the last event we had, I told you, them sneakers I wore was hard to just stand on. Because it's like rubber cleats. They look good.
That's it.
They didn't stand good.
Not comfortable.
I had to, you know, that night I had to stand like in the boxer's position the whole night just to stand up. He's DJing fine. Gallo DJed fine. Blade DJed fine. I had to, okay, hold on. Hold on. Let me get my balance. Because they're rubber cleats. You know? But I wore them once, and I told everybody, I said, these are a one-time wear.
That was part of the 50 then?
Yeah, it was part of the 50.
Wow. You know what number that was? You don't know when?
That number, I think it was 39. Huh. Yeah, that was at 39. And I was just
documented, like. Documented, like, pictures. Like, I would like to see.
How about this? I want to shout out to Al Prentice. He's going to be coming to S Street Media real soon. You know Al Prentice.
Yeah, I do.
And
shout out to Al.
He started it. Him and his crew started it. They documented 40 days online of wearing a new fit and sneakers. Right? And I said, I got y'all beat, man. I got y'all beat. And, you know, and I reminded him, I said, all of my brand new sneakers are for me performing or being on stage with MI6.
Now that's a stunt though, right? That's a quiet flex real quick. Hey, we're getting my fuck. They just for me to perform in. I don't have these shoes for like everyday life. They just for me to perform.
No, I'll be back in everyday life next week. Not here though. Gotcha. I got a new pair for next week already. Yeah, in a few days I'll be back to normal. Yeah, you know that's what happens when you're a sneakerhead. See, and what I don't like, C Black. Well, no, it's not that I don't like it. What I don't agree with is people buy sneakers for $400, $500, right? And as soon as you buy them, it lose value. I bought sneakers for less, and they're worth more.
How do they gain value?
Right.
How? I'm asking how.
Oh, how?
Yeah, how?
I don't wear them.
That's why. So some of the shoes you buy, you resell?
No, I don't. I'm not reselling nothing.
How does it gain value then?
Because it's rare.
Because it's rare, and the owner, it's rare. Ownership of it.
It's rare. Yeah.
Having it as a classic, the longer you have it, the more value it gains.
Yes.
I smell that shit. That's dope.
Yeah. And I got a lot of pairs like that. But, you know, like I said, in a week, I'm going to go back to normal. And, you know, I'm a. So what I have to do, C-Black, is you never been upstairs to my house. Damien has.
I actually have.
You've been upstairs?
I actually have.
Did you see the closet and the sneakers?
No, you showed me Lucy.
Oh. Well, yeah, that's a different story, people.
Exactly.
Yes. Yet.
I was introduced to Lucy.
I have to rearrange the closet so I could bring more sneakers from the front to the back. And, okay, I'm not wearing those anymore. And then, you know, so I could put on my kicks. And I could look as fly as you do.
Man, I'm just supporting PressFit Athletics.
Well, shouts to PressFit Athletics.
Shouts to PressFit Athletics.
You know, I wore your hoodie the other day.
Did you?
Yes, I did.
Did you take a picture?
No. You know I'm camera shy.
I don't believe that.
I'm extremely camera shy.
You always smiling in the camera. Chi ready.
How about this? And Super D, D Burgess can attest to this, right? When we first started doing the showcase, how many pictures was I in? And you were there for a good part of it.
I'm glad you said, since you want to go there. then what did it turn into? You was never camera shy for about 4 or 5 years.
I was camera shy.
Oh, no, you became the guy that had to be the guy.
Well, that's technically because I was the guy. Oh, no, we're talking about before Moshe.
I'm talking when it became that guy, what it turned into. This is what I'm saying. All of those pictures, you wasn't that guy. But then not being that guy turned into what guy?
Well, when Moshe OCL came out, I was promoting a record.
Camera.
Yeah. It was pictures everywhere.
All day, every day.
Yeah.
You wanted to be in it.
Exactly.
No. I like the way you're picking it up on. No. It's all under the Uncle Tone's brand still.
Yeah, but hold on. Do you remember when? Let me test your memory.
No, that's not
from Marfa to Bar 13 to Sapphire Lounge, I wore a hoodie and a sweatshirt. Every show.
Because you was packing.
Well, that's what the ladies say.
Nah. That. I'm talking about with the...
Well, that was always. That was always.
Yeah, you was...
And yes, I was a little more brolic.
No, I'm saying you was hooded up. No, you was hooded up because,
Yeah, because I
had a toolie.
I just came from out the street doing street things. Right. Super D and I, right? Yeah. Somebody had to protect us, right? And then once it was time for cheddar with an A, cheese with a Z-E, once I decided to put that out, I started wearing my jeans and stuff like that and all my gear. Because you got to remember, for y'all, when we did concerts and went out of town and had our little mini tours is when I would wear the new sneakers and the new gear. You dig what I'm saying? And then I fell back and went back to regular. Now that we're on S Street Media.
Now that you say it like that, I remember, yeah. Every trip you would. Yeah, it would be different. You would come out different.
Yeah.
You would bring the chains out.
Yeah, the chains would come out. The rings would come out.
Yeah, I can assess that.
And don't think you're going to come to my house. My jewelry is in my safe deposit box. So you're not getting to it. Yeah.
Yeah.
To this day. It always was it like before we would leave, I would go to the safe deposit box, take out my jewelry. And we'd be out. And then as soon as we got back, I would put my jewelry back in the safe deposit box. not a safe. So you're not even coming to my house and stealing the safe. Yeah, you're wasting your time. And I have a lot of jewelry.
That makes a lot of sense, though. I can remember that.
Yeah. But we did that. And, you know, with doing that, we're doing this now.
Just the parties? You can't.
Hmm?
You can't talk about the parties, you say?
I will talk about it next week with the permission from Mathematics and S Street Media and you and D Burgess. Because we have to coordinate the dates.
The dates? Oh, it's not even a date yet.
No, there's dates.
Oh, they are dates.
They're dates, yeah. They're dates. The concert is a different story. And the concert, I hate to surprise somebody in the room, but the concert is going to be Dice Hoods Entertainment, which is me and Nighttime's label, S Street Media, and the Grown Man Show in one. That's going to be the concert. Yeah, there's going to be a couple of shows in between, but the big one, is going to be all us partnering up doing it at one time. Of course, with D Burgess as the DJ, Gallo the Great as the DJ, and yes, unlike the last event, I'm stepping on the wheels.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, your rubber cleats.
No, I'm not wearing the rubber. You know what? Mathematics, S Street Media, D Burgess, this is the Grown Man Show. So you know how a lot of people say was? We ain't going nowhere.
I don't know who said was.
No, people say was when they close their show. This was another episode. No, I don't say was.
I got you.
Right, this is the Grown Man Show. Shouts to Hershey, Rapper the Rapper, Jacinda, Vanessa Smiles, Gallo the Great, D Burgess, Mathematics, my homegirl M, my nephew Thomas, C Black the Business. Follow him at that. C Black the Business. Spelled correctly.
Just like that.
Just like that. And I just happen to be a guy named DJ Uncle Tone. You don't have to follow me. I'll be deleting people. Let's take us out with a record, D Burgess.
I'm thinking cheddar cheese.
Oh, you want to end with cheddar cheese? Uh-oh.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Cheddar cheese,
Haiti,
got that cheddar cheese,
Dominican,
got that butter cheese,
can't.